Welcome everyone to 10 Minutes Math. Today we have IGCSE Cambridge International Exam Mathematics Paper 2 Extended, May-June 2018, 0580-22. Okay, let us start the first question. One morning, Marcia worked from 8:20 to 11:15. Find how long she works for. Give your answer in hours and minutes. So she start at 8:20 and finish at 11:15. So 11:15 minus 8:20. So start solve this question. Let us go to our calculator. 11 hour 15 minute minus 8 hour 20 minutes will give us 2 hour 55 minutes. So 2 hour 55 minutes. Now 7x expand 7x minus 8, so 7x minus 7 multiplied by 8. So it will be 7x minus 56. There is a sequence A 13, 9, 3, minus 5, minus 15, B, and so on. Find the value of A and value of B. 13 and 9 minus 4, 9 and 3 minus 6, 3 and minus 5 minus 8, 5 and minus 15 minus 10. So expected that another number here will be minus 12. So now B is equal to minus 15 minus 12 is equal to minus 27. So B is minus 27. What about A? Now here, from here, from 13 to 9 is minus 4 and then minus 6. So from 13 to A minus 2. So A is equal to 13 minus minus 2. So A is equal to 13 plus 2 is equal to 15. So A is 15. A is 15. Okay, let us go ahead. Complete this statement. When W is equal to 10W, equal to 7, so it's really, you can understand that W is equal to 7. 5x equal to 15, 12x is equal, again 5x is equal to 15, so x is equal to 3, so 12 multiplied by 3 equal to 36, so the answer here is 36. Work out difference between the two prime unit number in this list above, in the list above. Prime number means number without multiplication. You can't find this the number in the multiple table, multiplication table. So 22 is 2 by 11. 17, yes, 17 is prime number. 25, 5 by 5. 41 is a prime number. 39 is 13 by 3, 4 is 2 by 2. So the two prime number here is 41 and 17. He need the difference between them. So 41 minus 17. 41 minus 17, 41 minus 17 is equal to 24. So the answer here is 24. Let us see this question. Without using your calculator, work out 2 over 3 minus 1 over 12. Of course, you need to see all your work. So 2 over 3 minus 1 over 12, the common factor here is 12. 12 divided by 3 is equal to 4, 4 multiplied by 2 minus 1. So it will be 12, 4 multiplied by 2 is 8, minus 1, 7, over 12. The answer here is 7 over 12. B are two towns on the map. The bearing of A from B is 140. Work out the bearing of B from A. So I have B and I have A. The bearing from B. So I will go up here the north direction. Where is the bearing? The bearing angle will be here. 140. Now he need what? He need the bearing angle from B from A. So there is A and this is the north. Where is the angle he need? He need this angle. He want this angle. This total angle. The angle here, this angle is 180 minus 140 equal to 40. So this angle is 40. The bearing of B from A is equal to 360 minus 40. So the bearing will equal to 320. The total angle here is 360 minus 40 is equal to 320. Let's start this question. Here are some numbers written in standard form. From this number written, write down the largest number. Here 10 minus 1, 10 power 6, 10 power 0, 10 power 5, 10 power minus 3, 10 power minus 2. So the largest one is 10 power 6. So the largest number is 1.36 power 10 plus 6. The smallest number, the smallest again, is the smallest here, power minus 1, power 0, minus 5 plus 5, minus 3, minus 2. So the smallest one now is the one who has the biggest number here with minus. So 5.21, 10 minus 3. This is the smallest number. This is the smallest number. Let us go ahead to another question. Using a straight edge and the compass only, construct the locus of the point R equal R equal distance from A and B. So I need the equal distance from A and B. So you start to open your compass with the distance AB, distance AB. Then you stop here at A, then you stop here at A, and write upper curve and lower curve. With the same distance, go and with the same opening, go the B, and then start to make the curve and start to make another. Now, if you connect the two points here, this line has equal distance now from A and B. Now, when you connect the two points, now this line has equal distance from A to B. Okay? Let us go ahead. Factorize completely. XY plus 2Y plus 3X plus 6. So we let us take y as a common factor, so x plus 2 plus here, let us take 3 as a common factor, x plus 2. Now let us x plus 2 as a common factor, the remaining will be y plus 3. So your answer x plus 2, y plus 3. Okay, let us see the another question. The diagram show mathematically similar triangle T and U, two corresponding side lengths R 3 and 12. The area of the triangle T is 5 cm square. Find the area of the triangle U. The area of triangle T divided by the area of the triangle U was equal to 3 square divided by 12 square. So it will be 3 divided by 12 square. It will be 1 over 4 square equal to 1 over 16. Now area T is 5, so 5 centimeter squared divided by area U is equal to 1 over 16. So area for the triangle U is equal to 16 multiplied by 5 is equal to 80 centimeter squared. So the answer here is 80 centimeter squared. Okay, let us go ahead. Anna walks 31 kilometers at speed of 5 kilometers per hour. Both values are correct to the nearest whole number. Work out the upper boundary, the upper bound of the time taken from Anna to walk. Let us find the upper boundary, the time first. Now we have speed equal to distance divided by time. So time was equal to distance divided by speed. To find the upper boundary of time, so I need what? I need T max. Maximum T. I need what now? I need maximum distance and minimum speed. So the distance I need the maximum and the speed I needed minimum. Now, all of them is to nearest whole number, so 1 divided by 2 equal to 0.5. So T upper boundary or T maximum will equal to. The distance is 31. The maximum means upper boundary of the distance, so 31 plus 0.5. The minimum speed means here the minimum speed means 5 minus 0.5. This is the minimum, this is the lower boundary of the speed, and this is the upper boundary of the distance. If we do that, we find the maximum T or the upper boundary of the time. So it will be 31.5 divided by 4.5. Let us see. 31.5 divided by 4.5 will equal to 7 hours. So the time is equal to 7 hours. Let us start this question. The histogram shows information about the time T in minutes spent in a shop by each 80 people. Here is the frequency density. And here is the time per minute. Now time T per minute, T bigger than 0 less than 5 is equal to 6. We need the number of people when T bigger than 5, so here is 5, and less than 15, here is 15. We need the number of people here. This number here, the density is 1.5. So the number of the people will equal to, here the region is 10. So 10 multiplied by 1.5 equal to 15. So here the number will be 15. Now, bigger than 30, this is 30. Less than 50, this is 50. And the number up here is approximate 1.1. So to find again the number of the people, the area under the graph. So here this one is 20. So 20 multiplied by 1.1 is equal to 22. So the number here is 22. Okay. Let us go ahead. The diagram shows solid cuboid with a base area. The area at the base is 7 centimeters square. The value of the cuboid is 12 centimeter cube. Work out the total surface area. The total surface area. So we need the height h here. So h multiplied by the area was equal to the volume of the cuboid, which is equal to 21. So from here, h is equal to 21 divided by 7 equal to 3 centimeter. Okay. Now, how many faces we have? We have 6 faces to the cuboid. Upper face, lower face, side face, and another side, and the front, and the another front. So every part, we need the total surface area. Every part has two rectangles. Upper rectangle, lower one, and the side, and the another side, and then the front rectangle, and the another rectangle. So the area is equal to, the first one is here, 7 multiplier by height. The height here, 7 multiplier by the height. This is the front L, which is 7 multiplier by 3 multiplier by 2 because it's the two faces, plus. The second one is here, 1, the side area, this one. The side area is equal to 1 by the H. H is equal to 3. So 1 by 3 by 2. Why 2? Because we have face here and the face here at the back. The top will equal to 7 multiplier by here. This distance is 1. So plus 7 by 1 by 2. Okay. So let us see how much this area. 7 by 3 by 2 plus 1 by 3 by 2 plus 1 by 7 by 2. The total surface area of this cuboid is 62 centimeter square. 62 centimeter square. Okay. Find the volume of the cylinder, radius 5, and the height 8 centimeter. Give the units of your answer. So the unit here has one mark. The unit here has one mark. So the volume of the cylinder will be pi r squared h. So pi, the radius is 5 square, the height is 8. So the answer, pi by 5 square by 8. So the answer here, the area is equal to 600. 28.32 centimeter cube. Okay, 628.32 centimeter cube. So we will write here 628.32 and centimeter cube. This part here, one mark, and this part, one mark. And the answer here is one mark. So 3 marks divided by 1, 1, 1. Every one is one mark. Okay. Let us go ahead. The diagram shows a circle center O. So the center is O. AB is a chord of length 12 centimeters. So AB total is 12 centimeters. M is the midpoint of AB. So M is the midpoint. So here 6 and here 6. Midpoint of AB and OM will equal to 4.5. OM 4.5. Calculate the radius of the circle. You need the radius of the circle. So he need this line, which is R. So from this triangle, this is angle 90. So according to Pythagoras, r square is equal to 6 squared plus 4.5 squared. So the radius r is equal to square root of 6 squared plus 4.5 squared. let us bring our calculator. Square root of 6 square plus 4.5 square. The radius of the circle was equal to 7.5 centimeters. So it is equal to 7.5 centimeter. Here the answer 7.5 centimeter. Okay. Let us go ahead to another question. The diagram shows information about the first 8 seconds of car journey. The car traveled with constant acceleration, reached a speed v meter per second after 6 seconds. So after 6 seconds, we reach v. The car traveled at constant speed v for two more seconds. The car total distance is 150 meters. Find v. You need to find the velocity. As you know, distance was equal to area of the triangle plus area of the rectangle. This area of this triangle plus the area of here of this rectangle. So let us find the total distance is 150. The area of the triangle is half base. Base is here. So the base is 6 multiplied by the height. The height is this height, which is V. Plus the area of the rectangle will be here. This dimension is 2. 2 multiplied by the another side, which is V. 2 multiplied by V. So let us go ahead. 150 is equal to 3V plus 2V, 5V. So V is equal 150 divided by 5 equal to 30 meter per second. So V is equal 30 meter per second. You must add the unit. You must add the unit. Okay, let us go ahead. A ball falls d meters in t second. D is directly proportion to the square of t. So d is directly proportion of t squared. The ball falls 401 meter in 3 seconds. Find the value for d in term of t. So we can write d is equal to kt square. So at distance equal to 44.1, the time is equal to 3 squared. So from this equation, k is equal, let us use our calculator, 44.1 divided by 3 square will equal to 4.9. So k is 4.9, so the d is equal to 4.9 t square. So we can write the equation here, 4.9 t square. Calculate the distance of the ball. Falls in 2 seconds. So the distance is equal to 4.9 multiplied by 2 square, 2 seconds square. So the distance is equal to 4.9 by 2 square. So the distance is equal to 19.6 meter. Why meter? Because here is meter. So the answer will be 19.6, and here write the unit meter. Okay, let us go ahead. Find two inequalities that define the region of the grid that not shaded. We need all the area here which is not shaded. I can add this area as a up from this line and up from this line. So this line, the equation of this line here is y equal to here x1, y equal to 2, x2, y equal to 2, and x3, y equal to 2. So y equal to 2. This is dashed line, so it will not be any equal. This is bigger than, so y is bigger than 2. Without equal. So the first part here is y bigger than 2. Y is bigger than 2 without equal, because this one is a dashed line, not continuous line. If continuous line, we add equal. If there is hidden line or dashed line, there is no equal. The second line here, which is this line, at 0, y is equal to 3. So the first point, 0 and 3. Second point is here, which is 3 and 0. 3 and 0. Y is equal to mx plus c. M is equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So it will be 0 minus 3, 0 minus 3, 3 minus 0. 3 minus 0. So it will be minus 3 divided by 3 equal to minus 1. So m of this line equal to minus 1. At x equal to 0, y equal to 3. So 3 is equal to m multiplied by 0 plus c. So from here, c is equal to 3. So the equation of the line y is equal to minus x plus 3. This is the equation of the line. Here is the area over the line, so y bigger than and equal. Y bigger than and equal, because again, this is a continuous line now. So bigger than or equal minus x plus 3. Minus x plus 3. Let us see this question. We have four matrix A, B, C, and I. Here are four matrix calculation, AI, IA, C2, C square, and P plus I. Work out which matrix calculation does not give the answer 1199. As you know, AI, I here is 1001, so this is a zero matrix. So AI will give us AI will give us A, and the A is 1199. So the first one is 1. IA will give us A. So 1199. So again, this is wrong. Now P plus I, P plus I. Let us see. 1 plus 1, 0 plus 1, 0 plus 1, 1 plus 0, and 9 plus 0, 8 plus 1. So the answer here will be 1199. So also this one is give us the answer. So the answer here for this question, definitely the one will not give us 119, it will be C. Find the determinant of B. The determinant of matrix B, B is 0, 1, 9, 8. So the determinant of B will equal to 0 multiplied by 8 minus 1 multiplied by 9. So it will be minus 9. Minus 9. Explain why matrix A has no inverse if the determinant of matrix A is equal to 0, so there is no inverse for this matrix. Let us see. 1, 1, 9, 9. So determinant of A will equal to 1 multiplied by 9 minus 1 multiplied by 9, so 0. So it doesn't have any inverse because the determinant of A is equal to 0. So because the determinant of A is equal to 0, there is no inverse for this matrix. Okay. Let us go ahead. The scatter diagram shows the value in $1,000 of 8 houses in 1996 and the value of the same houses in 2016. So here is the value in 2016 and here is the value of 1996. One of these 8 houses has a value of 17,000 in 1996. Write down the value of the house in 2016. So at 1996, which is here, the value of this house is 70,000. So here, so I need to go up from 70, and then I find the value of this house is in 2016. So I go up here from 7,000. Now this is the value here at 2016. So the value is $140,000. $140,000. Okay. Now the value of the two more house are shown in the table. Value in 1996 is 40 and 80 in 2016, 80 and 150 in 2016. On the scatter diagram, plot this value. So we need to add this value. So we'll go for 40 here. And then we will go up 40, 40, 40, 40 until we reach 80. So the value will be here exactly. So you need to add X here. The second one is 80 with 150, 80 here. We go up, 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 up until we reach 150. 150 is more up. So 80 here, we go up, 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 up. And we go up here for 180 until you reach 150 and then you put your point. On the scatter diagram, draw line of the best fit. So we need to connect all of this line with a line with fit. You draw a line with approximate best fit to all the point. Another house had value of 50,000 in 1996. So it's 50,000 in 1996. Find the estimate value of this house in 2016. So from 50 here, we will go up until we reach this value here. So this value approximate 100,000. Approximate 100,000. So the estimate value of this house in 2016 will be 100,000. $100,000. Okay. Let us go ahead to this question. In the diagram, O is the origin. So O is the origin. OC is equal to minus 2A plus 3B as a vector. And OD as a vector is equal to 4A plus B. And the DE as a vector is A minus 2B. Find the CD. You need CD. So OC as a vector plus CD as a vector is equal to OD as a vector. So again, O C as a vector plus C D as a vector is equal to O D as a vector. O C is equal to minus 2A plus 3B plus C D as a vector is equal to 4 O D is equal to 4A plus B. So CD as a vector is equal to 4A plus 2A plus B minus 3B. So CD as a vector is equal to 6A minus 2B. 6A minus 2B. Let us go ahead. DE is equal to A minus 2B. Find the position vector E of E in the term of A and B. This is the origin O, so the position of E is equal to OD plus DE. So OD, which is 4A plus B plus DE, which is A minus 2B. So it will be 5A minus B. So 5A minus B. Again, the position here of E is equal to OE, which is OD plus DE. Let us see the Venn diagram. Show the information about number of elements set A and B and Z. Number of A union B is equal to 23. Find the value of X. A union B means all the elements here in A and B. So 20 minus X plus X plus 8 minus X is equal to 23. So minus X plus X. So 20 plus 8 minus X is equal to 23. So minus X is equal to 23 minus 28. So 23 minus 28 minus 5 minus and minus. So 5 is X is equal to 5. An element is chosen at random from Z. Find the probability that this element is in A union B dash. A union B dash. A union B dash. A union B dash. All the element at A and B or the outside element of A union B. So this one will equal to 7. And A union B is equal to 23. And all Z is equal to 23 plus 7, plus this 7. So all A and B is 23 plus 7 will equal to 30. So the probability here, I choose random from Z, and it will be probably find here in this A union B dash, it will be equal to 7. Divided by 30. 7 divided by 30. Okay. Let us read this question. Box A and box B each contain blue and green pen only. Rochelle picks a pen at random from box A and Paolo picks a pen random from box B. The probability that Rochelle picks a blue pen is 2 over 3. The probability both Rochelle and Paolo pick blue pen is 8 over 15. Find the probability that Paolo picks a blue pen. So let us understand this question. The probability that Rochelle will pick blue pen is 2 over 3. The probability both Rochelle and Paolo pick blue pen is 8 divided by 15. So Rochelle multiplied by Paolo is equal to 8 over 15. Now, Rochelle, probability of Rochelle to pick the blue is 2 over 3. 2 over 3 multiplied by the probability of Paolo is equal to 8 divided by 15. So B, which is the probability of Paolo, will equal to 8 divided by 15 multiplied by 3 divided by 2. So the probability here is 4 over 5. So the probability that Paolo pick blue pen is 4 over 5. Find probability that both Rachel and Paolo pick green pen. Both of them will pick green pen. So to understand how to work this question, let us go. Rochelle, to have a blue pen, 2 over 3. So to have a green, this is blue, this is here blue, green, 1 over 3. Paolo, to pick blue, 4 over 5. What about green? This is blue now. Blue, 4 over 5. Green, how much? 1 over 5. So both of them to pick green, 1 over 3, 1 over 5. So both of them pick green will equal to 1 over 3 multiplied by 1 over 5. So the answer is 1 over 15. 1 over 15. Again, Rochelle pick blue, 2 over 3. So to pick green, 1 over 3. Paolo to pick blue, 4 over 5. So Paolo to pick green, 1 over 5. So 1 over 3 multiplied by 1 over 5 equal to 1 over 15. B is 0.16 and 9. Q is a 0.22 and 24. Find the equation of the line perpendicular. So not the line PQ, it's perpendicular to PQ. Pass through the 0.5 and 1, give your answer in the formula of y equal to mx plus c. As you know, slope is equal to m y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So it will be 24 minus 9 divided by 22 minus 16. 24 minus 9. 24, let us make the equation, 24 minus 9 divided by 22 minus 16. So the slope will equal to 5 over 2. So the slope of this line, BQ, this is the slope of MBQ. And the perpendicular is equal to 1 over m minus here. Will equal to minus 1 over m mpq. So it will be minus 2 over 5. This is a perpendicular. This is a perpendicular line. The equation y equal to mx plus c. So y will equal to minus 2 over 5x plus c. Now at y equal to 1, x will equal to 5 according to the given data here. Plus c, so 1 equal to minus 2 plus c, so c is equal to 3. So the equation will be minus 2 over 5x plus 3. This is the equation of the perpendicular line. N is a point on PQ such that PN is equal to N, 2NQ. So let me draw. This is B. This is Q. N is here. Somewhere here. So PN is equal to 2 n cube. So here 2, here 1. So I can write now Pn is equal to 2 over 3 bq. And nq here, and here nq is equal to 1 over 3 bq. We need the coordinate of n, the coordinate of n. Let me write the coordinate of each point. Point B here is 16 and 9. And point Q here, the coordinate is 22 and 24. Let us start to write the equation for n. X, n, which is the coordinate of n, was equal to the coordinate of B, X coordinate of B, which is 16, plus 2 over 3, x coordinate of bq. What is the coordinate, the x coordinate of bq, the x coordinate of bq, the x coordinate of bq is equal to xq minus xb, which is equal to 22 minus 60. So xn is equal to 16 plus 2 over 3, 22 minus 16. 22 minus 16. So the coordinate, the x coordinate of n is equal to, let us start, 16 plus 2 over 3 by 22 minus 16. So it would equal to 20. So the x coordinate here is 20. Let us repeat the same for y. Yn is equal to the first coordinate of b, which is 9, plus 2 over 3 ybq. Ybq is equal to yq minus y. B, yq minus yb, which is equal to 24 minus 9. So it will be 9 plus 2 over 3, 24 minus 9. So 9 plus 2 over 3 by 24 minus 9 will equal to 19. So the coordinate of n is 20 and 19. This is the last question. Thank you. Bye.